Hello again, everybody, and welcome to our weekly interview on WWE.com. I'm Michael Cole, and my guests this week, two men who, two of my favorite men in the history of this business, D-Von, Bubba Ray, the Dudley Boyz. Welcome, guys.
Thank you. How are you?
Good to be here.
I'll tell you what, that night in Brooklyn, wow, the night after SummerSlam, I had no idea the Dudley Boyz were returning. And when that pyro hit and you guys came out, I swear to God, I felt like a kid on Christmas Day again. It was an incredible, incredible moment. It must have been awesome for you guys.
Well, I think just like 18,000 people, you know, like you, you know, you thought it was an incredible moment. So did 18,000 plus in that arena. Me and Bubba, I think we've been waiting for that for a long time, to be able to come back home to the WWE universe and the WWE fans. It was just one of those things where it was the right time to do it. And we were just extremely happy, overwhelmed with the reception that we got at the Barclays Center. To know that the WWE universe never forgot us was really, really heartwarming for both of us. And I guess you can tell from the excitement of us coming down when we first came out. I know Bubba and I decided to go, he's supposed to go left and I was supposed to go right, and I went the opposite.
You were supposed to go left.
See, I'm still confused.
I was supposed to go right. The cool thing about it was that's the great part of our industry when you can keep a secret. Nobody knew. And there's different kind of reactions from fans when you come out. And that was what I like to call a shock pop. It's a different reaction. It's when you can grab them emotionally by their heartstrings and just rip at them. And they're like, oh my God, I never, ever expected this. And they have no choice but to be completely ecstatic. And that's what it was that night. It's cool as all hell.
So what have you guys been up to over the 10 years since you've been here?
Everything.
Yeah, I mean, we've been New Japan, All Japan, the great organizations over in Japan, and just being very active all over around the world. You know, we never stopped working. We just continue to go nonstop. And one of the things is, you know, Bubba and I like to say that we like to take over where the Road Warriors, you know, left off. And in order for us to have done that, we had to make stops in Japan and then continue to go all around the world. And we were able to do that.
But why now? Why this moment in time did the Dudley Boyz come back to WWE?
Because timing is everything. Mm-hmm. And this was the perfect time. Me and D-Von in the past 10 years have been traveling all over the world, conquering the rest of the world when it comes to tag team wrestling. We also opened up our own school in Kissimmee, Florida, our own academy to help the up-and-coming wrestlers to train. We've been very involved with our industry outside of the WWE. But when we sat back and we always watch the product, we always keep, keep a feel, for what's going on in the WWE universe. We saw that the tag teams were starting to gain some steam again, especially a team like the New Day, okay? And starting to create a little bit of a stir and a buzz and becoming entertaining. And that's when we said to ourselves, all right, the time is right. We've been gone for 10 years. And if we could throw ourselves into the mix now, we could help the tag team division in the WWE get back to the level that it once was.
The New Day, you mentioned the new tag team champions. Do you guys find them entertaining?
You know, I think New Day is a very, very, good team. I think they're very entertaining. But, that's something that we pride ourselves on when we first came into the business as being entertaining, but also being kick-ass guys. I think New Day is trying to follow in the Dudley Boyz footsteps because they're doing pretty much everything that we used to do back in the day to get, attention.
Did you ever play the trombone?
I played a little bit.
I heard.
Yeah, really?
That you play the trombone?
Stop it.
But it's going to take the New Day 20 years to get to your point because, as you've mentioned on a number of occasions, this coming February, it'll be 20 years that the Dudley Boyz have been together.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
But D-Von told me earlier that your timing's all messed up. It was actually April.
Yeah.
Oh, is it? He might be right. April, oh, it's April.
April 13th. Yeah, in Queens.
April 13th is pretty close to April 3rd.
No, it's not. You said February.
Yes, it is. What is April 3rd?
WrestleMania.
Ah, yes.
Wow, that would be... Wow.
So D-Von's better now, right?
See? We planned it this way. This is why we came back
this
now.
Is what we wanted to be on the biggest stage at WrestleMania in Dallas,
We wanted
Texas.
To be in the middle of the star.
Finally, before we get to WrestleMania, a week from Saturday, only on the WWE Network, live from Madison Square Garden. Special start time of 7:30 Eastern, 4:30 Pacific. The Dudley Boyz meet the New Day for the WWE Tag Team Titles. What would it mean to you guys to win your 10th Tag Team Championship in Madison Square Garden?
Well, check this out, okay? I got to come back at the Royal Rumble in Philadelphia this year, okay? Which was incredible. Me and D-Von got to come back together in Brooklyn, which was off the charts. Mm-hmm. Now, to have the opportunity to win our 10th World Tag Team Championship in Madison Square, in our backyard, in the arena that I went to and he went to mm-hmm. growing up as a kid, in the arena where the MSG Network that we watch as kids, to win those championships in that building mm-hmm. in front of our hometown, it doesn't get any better. I don't even want to sound, it's like so cliche, How could it get any better? I'll turn the question on you. How do you think it would be for us to win the championships that day?
Absolutely incredible.
It'd be great.
One of the things is that, like you said, we grew up in New York. We've been to, Madison Square Garden. We've watched all of the greats go through those doors. And to be able to come back after 10 years to step foot in there, and on top of that, to be able to, go for the championship on that particular night, my God, you have no idea. Butterflies are going to be flying, but yet, tables might be going too.
Good luck at the Garden. Finally, can you guys do it once for me? Can you give me the D-Von yell? D-Von, get the...
We could do it, but mm-hmm. if we did it, we'd have to put you through a table.
Yeah, I don't think you would want that, Mike.
Do you?
No.
Are you sure?
No, I'll pass.
There were some discouraging words that he said about 10 years ago about
Come
us.
Come on, you don't have this a memory like that.
My memory is very good. He even said those damn Dudleys, and he said it with conviction, like as if we did something to him. And it wasn't for the
fact that you buried us.
Thank you very much for joining us. Good luck at Madison Square Garden, and
see,
I'll
see
totally
you guys. He's just totally disregarding you.
Blowing me off.
The D-Von that I knew would have just punched him square in the face.
You mean like this?
Thanks, guys.
Thank you.
Thank you.